Hello and welcome to Short Comic Introduction. Today we're taking a look at an adult comic, meaning there is not safe for work stuff in there like nudity, violence and gore. So just keep in mind when you check it out. So yeah, the comic we're talking about today is called Alien Hand Syndrome by Drake. The comic started in July 2011. And there is one thing I should mention before you check it out. The update schedule is very, very irregular. This has to do with a problem the artist has with his hand or wrist. He can't draw or work very long without the wrist hurting him. So yeah, keep that in mind if you check that out. And also keep that in mind if you see his work, because I will be honest, it's absolutely astonishing to see how he's creating his work, or how detailed the art itself really looks. He has a very unique art style, very sharp sharp lines, a lot of shading, again a very sharp shading, and he's looking about about perspective and detail work on the characters and also the backgrounds themselves. So it's really amazing what he can do with a kind of injured wrist in so many ways. But again, the same, he has the problem that he can't work that long with it. So yeah, just keep that in mind. But again, the artwork is it's really amazing. There are some parts I'm not so sure if they really work. Sometimes I have to say the characters look a little bit off, but not that that great that it's somehow taking you out of the story or the comic. But again, just a small piece. The art itself, like I said, absolutely gorgeous in many ways, and even more, like I said, the comic started in 2011, and if you take a look at the first pages and how the latest pages look, the evolution of his artwork, again amazing. It's really amazing to see how this artist has how his art has changed from the beginning to now, and with everything you know about his wrist. So yeah, even if you don't, if you just want to look how interesting art can look, just take open the page. But like I said, not safe for work warning. So yeah, what's the story about? The story is following Mina, who is living a shut-in lifestyle, who one day gets an invitation to a vacation from Erin, a girl from a rich family who somehow has a crush on her. And while on vacation, Mina accidentally breaks some kind of stone and gets possessed by a spirit. Now, the comic is, to be honest, still in its very early stages. Even we're in chapter 4, but at the moment, the more mystery part with the spirit is still a little bit downplayed. The story is at the moment at a part where we get a little bit more information about what's going on, but mostly the first three chapters are just about these two girls, how they interact with each other, how they see each other in some way, and yeah, on their vacation, and what is slowly happening with Mina after she broke the stone, because the whole story is beginning in a way that at first she's just hallucinating about things she would do or bad things she would do, and later she's really doing this. So meaning the spirit is slowly starting to possess her, or only has partially control over her. So and this is a part of this whole storyline, but let's see where it's going. And the interesting part is about this story, the artist in this case Drake has a very interesting idea, and the name of the comic has to do with it. He came on it after he watched some kind of documentary about a condition called Alien Hand Syndrome. And I think he's doing really he has a really interesting way to write this whole story, because at first Or let's see, like I said, the first three chapters are mostly just the interaction of our characters with their surroundings and all these side characters. And the way they interact is a very natural flow. Even if these kind of hallucinations come into it, it never felt like they're out of place. You always get this, what's going on now? And then you're taking back directly into back to the story, out of this hallucination. They're seamless going into each other, and a very, very fascinating way to write this or write a story. It works in so many ways. Also, the way the characters interact with each other, especially in the later pages, feels very natural. I never had the feeling that when they talked with each other or did something with each other, that it felt fake. Everything they did, everything they talked about, felt again very natural in a flow that you can think that this is something. If you see some people do this, you never will think about that it's something they or that it's just something written for them. You can feel that it's this is a conversation everyone could have with each other, even if in the latest pages. To be honest, when let's say it this way, they get explained what's going on and try to find out a little bit more about what happened to Mina. Even these conversations, they are let's keep it that they are fantasy conversations. But again, I never had the feeling that this is just something that is just written there. Again, it feels very normal how they interact with each other, especially when these two exorcists who worship Sol Invictus come into play. It's a very natural flow from everything, and I really enjoy this, especially after the beginning, because even if I praise the way he's writing his story, at the beginning I had some small problems with the way Eren tried to win over Mina. Sometimes I had the feeling the way she tried it was just too direct. Let's put it this way. I know there are people out there who would do the same like she did, but this was the only time I thought throughout the whole story that it looked a little bit fake to me. Like I said, only at the beginning, only at in for mostly in the first chapter, but after that, it slowly came down, and like I said, it went a very natural flow. I think here Drake found its found his line where he said, "Yes, this is the way I will continue writing the story." And I really hope, even if he may never finish the comic from the artwork part of it, that he w because he can't draw anymore, or it would be too much for his too much strain on his hand, that he will write or will continue to write his story, because I think there are a lot of parts that could get interesting, especially the humor. I think the humor again works very great, because it's the way he's writing his conversations, the humor that he puts in there, it never felt fake. It felt like some of the gags came just very natural. If you talk about someone and he's just getting, what did she say? What just happened? And also the characters, how they react after hearing, especially Mina, after she's hearing what she had done, and she can't remember that she has done it. And it's a very interesting writing style, but still we are at the beginning, and I hope we see more in the future of him. And again, if you're interested to support him, comment under the pages, and if you want to support him a little bit more, he has its own Patreon page. I will leave the link down below. just to keep in mind, like I said, it's an adult comic, and if you check out his webpage, there is another comic he's creating. It's just started, called Growing Closer. Again, it's a very, I would put there nothing had ha has happened in there, but the way the comic is has started, it's just be careful. This is also a not safe for work comic and an adult comic, so keep that in mind. So yeah, I would say it's definitely a recommendation to check out. I know not many people, or there will be some people be out there that won't enjoy it, especially the way Mina and Eren interact with each other and about some of the themes. But give it a chance. It's really not a bad comic, and it has really some things going for it. And let's hope he somehow finds a way to continue the story with or without artworks, because it would be a shame to lose this one. It has a lot of potential. So again, thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye.